The seven-member ad hoc committee, chaired by the Mbarara South legislator Mwine Mpaka, has today commenced proceedings into the case of censure against the state minister for housing, Persis Namuganza.
Namuganza, Princess, state minister for lands, housing and urban development, being misbehavior and misconduct. Honorable members, the conduct of Honorable Persis Namuganza, Princess, was examined by the Rules, Privilege and Discipline in its report on the inquiry into allegations of misconduct and misbehavior against Honorable Persis Namuganza, State Minister for Lands, Housing and Urban Development.
The behavior of a member shall be guided by the code of conduct of members prescribed in Appendix F. The code of conduct, Honorable Chair and members, the code of conduct of members of Parliament in paragraph 3G requires that a member to promote and support good governance by leadership and example. My emphasis here is on example, Honorable Chair.
Led by the Agago North MP, John Amos Okot, the mover of the censure motion, and his seconder, Jonah Musinguzi, MPs made a case before the committee, pinning Namuganza on gross misconduct.
I want to bring to your memory that there are many evidences that I've been presenting. And even I say, video recordings, beside all what I've been putting, I've been examining the current situations, the behaviors, and all the conducts he had already exhibited within now. And I say, no, let me move one step backward and see. Could it be that this kind of behaviors is one of that I'm witnessing now, or there has also been a similar kind of
behavior? I believe the evidence my brother here has furnished is enough, but however, I wanted to clarify on what the framers of the Constitution really were putting across in 118 on misbehavior and misconduct, such that it can also help us and guide us as a committee. Mr. Chair, though you've told us not to go so far away from the 11th Parliament, but for misbehavior to be quantified and qualified, we cannot just stop at the cover page of what has happened.
Namuganza's accusers tabled evidence including video clips material recorded recently from the accused minister while using what they called unparliamentary language that amounts to misconduct, and asked the committee to accept and admit their evidence.
And alleged to be unparliamentary, and the connection of those unparliamentary words to the particular ground you are relying on of misconduct and misbehavior. And if those particular and parliamentary statements indeed amount to misconduct and misbehavior, is it only one?
I will lay after I've got the flash. There is a clip where the Honorable Minister refers to members of Parliament as ignorant, which is part of the clip. When you examine the videos, you will get it.
The presiding officer, the way you said it, in that language, you take us to the rule they could have contravened in the process, so that when we are writing a report, we look at what you are stating and we compare and make a judgment.
However, they struggled to answer questions put against them by the committee members and the chairperson, Mwine Mpaka, tasked them to go back and bring proper evidence in writing.
Proper response in writing, unless you are comfortable with the proceeding and giving us the responses now. But from that preamble you have given us, I have not seen any response to any of the questions that have been raised by the honorable members. So I am just guiding that you take time and give us a very good response and submit it in writing.
Namuganza, who was summoned in the meeting today to cross-examine the witnesses, was a no-show in the meeting. It's not clear whether she will show up tomorrow when she is expected to defend herself on accusations leveled against her. The committee has disclosed all evidence that has been gathered today to the minister to prepare her defense tomorrow. A motion for the censure was moved following the recommendation by the Rules, Privileges and Discipline Committee, which found Namuganza to have misbehaved by bringing Parliament into disrepute. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.